hell yeah. Nice. Hey, what's up, Cinders? I don't have many hours, and I'm not good. I just get lucky. I don't even know if luck is what you would call it. I just think it's just a freak accident. I have like literally no luck in that game, and that was like the one time I actually did good or decent. I only have 40 hours in here. Yeah. Hey, look, he actually talks this time. It's amazing. It's amazing. It takes one person to say something wrong, and everybody at the peanut gallery just... all the lurks come to fruition. Yeah. Some riveting commentary. Yeah, well, you know. It's whatever. I appreciate the view, though. I mean, yeah. That's nice of you to take the actual time to try and find me on Twitch. I never actually professed at being any good at this game. This is just a game that I played for fun, you know? Hence why I'm not too bothered with a whole lot of things. Except for when I'm missing stuff that obviously I shouldn't have missed, but whatever. Like I said, I only have 40 hours in the game. I don't really play this game that much. 40 hours since the game first came out. What games am I good at? Let's see. I primarily play Elite Dangerous. I play, Old Republic, Empyrean. What don't I play? This game I actually have the least amount of playtime on. Yeah, you're not helping, Baron. Thank you. I can't tell if that's a compliment or an insult. But I mean, since I don't spend 500 hours in one game... Yeah, you think I'm gonna fall for that again? No. But you just gave me 100 points, so I appreciate it. I should specialize as a comedy show. Thanks. Oh man. Oh, damn. I think tonight is one of those nights where I just freaking can't get anything right as a killer. But that's just it's a grind fest, I guess. Are you kidding me? I missed that. Wow. There we go. Well, only three hits and one. How about you don't ever? Now you can go fuck off and never return. And profess it being a very good killer. I know I'm not a very good killer. All these guys have single perk or less. So I didn't profess it being very good at the game. You know how many hours I have in this game? I've got 40 hours. I've got a work week in this game. Since the game came out, I don't live on this game. I've got other games that I play. I'm only on this game because I have friends that are also streamers that want to do ranked Survivor. So they told me get on here and get some points into Survivor so you have multiple perks. That's what I'm doing. If I have to grind it out as a killer or as a survivor, then I'm going to do it. But I'm not going to have some dickhole that can't fucking tell his ass from a hole in the ground come in here and start telling me exactly how I'm going to play. And then he's going to give me more experience. He's going to give me lessons and he doesn't even fucking play a killer. You can go do the world a favor and promptly go stick your head in the toilet and take 10 deep breaths for all I give a shit. Okay? My worst round so far. Just remember, Baron, you can fix a broken nose, right? You can repair someone's sight. You can improve their looks, but you cannot fix stupid. Okay? trying to help. Yes, he was helping us and showing us how some folks are incredible assholes. I'm not even bothering now. They can just go do all the points they want. Let's see. Let's take a look at who we... I like the, Cinders, let's take a look. 124 followers. But you're gonna come into my channel and... Alright, so you're gonna come into a stream another streamer's channel, and first of all, being an ass to him. And so you're going to sit here and spiel off. As you are. I can handle sarcastic. I can handle being people being incredibly sarcastic, actually. I tell you what, I will make a decision for you. Bye. There's an unwritten rule between fellow Twitch streamers, and when you come into another streamer's channel, you're respectful. When you come in and you've been basically lurking the entire time watching me play, so first of all, you're getting metadata off of me, just watching where I am while I'm playing, to see what I'm doing. So now this gives you an advantage in the game. I can't get to you because you know where I am, in a rough area, even though it's a 10-second delay. Oh. You can promptly just, see your way out of the channel. Much appreciated. Don't come back. I'm sure you wouldn't like it if someone else came into your game and stream sniped you. So, like I said, you can go bye-bye and enjoy your little corner of Twitch. I'm sure people enjoy watching you play one game. But just don't come here anymore, okay? All right? We're good. I do appreciate the view, though. See, the funny part being the fact that when I'm playing Elite Dangerous, I have more viewers than he has followers, and he's gonna come in and basically say this and that about how I'm playing the game. I play this game only for fun, okay? I got a challenge from Gabe last night to play and get one of my survivors up to a certain level so that we can all do some ranked survivor. I had to play 2 hours straight as a survivor or 5 straight wins. I managed to get to do both, actually, and I kept on playing. And out of all the trolls that come into the channel on a occasional basis, I only think I've only thrown the hammer 3 or 4 times. So to have the distinction of actually having the hammer thrown at you, that's guess that's prestigious enough. Put your name up on the Hall of Shame. Got a lot more optimized since launch. Yeah, Strike, I have not played that one yet. Oh, another one. Congratulations. You immediately get banned. That's awesome. Great job. Yeah, my mods might be asleep. That's okay. Doesn't mean I can't throw the hammer just as quickly. Yeah. It's just Cinders and his followers. See, the funny part is the fact that you invalidated your statement just by having little K-Wom come in here and say, "Oh yeah, we enjoyed watching you play your games on the 2 occasions that we played against you." So that statement right there means that you were watching me while we were in a match together, which is technically the literal definition of a stream snipe. And, you know, hey, you don't like being... You don't
Good
like
morning,
being
gentlemen.
Banned?
The temperature is 110 degrees. Holy
okay.
Shit, it's Viper!
That's okay. Nothing you can do about it. I'm the only one that can lift it. Golden Fox, thanks for the host, man. I appreciate it. You can ask any of my followers. The amount of hours per week that I play this game is almost nothing. All right? The only reason I'm even playing this today is because I was offered a challenge, which I accepted because I never turned them down. By my friends, which are also other streamers. So, it's whatever. No, I haven't played. I have not played Fallout 4 at all. I was waiting for it to go down in price, but then when I heard that the game wasn't really well optimized, I kind of, you know, I kind of just decided, okay, well, I'll wait till it is, and then I'll revisit it. And you... Yeah, I just had three trolls come in, basically, Andy, and I had to throw the hammer on all three of them. I'm still learning the game. So these guys are taking the time to create new accounts to come in and well, not even worth it at this point. Oh yeah, this is true, Andy. This is true. I get so distracted by what's going on in the chat that I don't even have a chance to play. There she is. How the hell did I manage to miss that? Whatever. Oh. Thank you. someone streaming this right now? Is that why everybody's coming in here? Jeez. I did two or three of them, Andy. But that's only because they were, they decided to taunt me the whole time. Yeah, I know, Andy. Yeah, I need to get a video. I need to get a video for the trolls. I really do. Ah, my God. The best part being the fact that I've banned three of them, and two are still here. Do I want the video? No, I was gonna... I mean, I can make a different one, Andy. Hey, what's up? What's up, Etherhead? You're missing all the fun and excitement. I'm doing terribly, but I keep getting more people to come in. Yeah, I can get later from you, Andy. I do appreciate it. Come on. Hey, look, we got four lot lizards. What the hell? There's... Well, yeah, this should be a little weird. Two of them, I won't be able to tell apart at all.
I feel the need.
The need.
And then he throws me a follow. Okay, thanks for the follow, Pam Tiki, even though you're banned. Appreciate it.
Hey,
I tell you what, I will not ban you guys forever. I'm a fair guy. I will give you a second chance. I will clear the ban queue after tonight. After I'm done streaming, I'm fair. I give two chances. Okay, thanks, Andy. What's up, Stroik? Awesome. Thanks, Andy. Let me, alright, here we go. Up to my hitting people by accident. I don't know what I'm doing, I'm just doing it. I'm just lucky, I guess. So my killer has one perk. This one has one perk. Oh, and Andy, by the way, that spine perk, I got the very rare one. I just took all my points that I got from the killer and put it over to Survivor, and I got the very rare version of it. That's that one that you were telling me to make sure to grab. There, look what we got. Yeah. Hey. Why can't I pick you up? There we go. Well, hey, I heard that you got all wet and whatnot, so I'll just hang you up here and you can dry out some. Shh! They're gonna hear you. Yeah, I was, you know, putting her up there so she could dry out a little bit, but, you know, hey. When it gets a little too real. What'd I say? I didn't say anything bad. But apparently I can't, you know, pay attention to what's going on. When you start playing Dead by Daylight with GoPro and real hammer, I'm sure there's probably someone that's made a, you know, a webisode of it or something. I could see it now. Some YouTuber has probably done that. You like that part? Well, she was screaming. They, meaning the other survivors. Duh. No, I'm kidding, Strike. There's fires, they're gonna hear you. Keep quiet. My god, I am not freaking. I'm in the wrong place at the wrong time. Apparently I was there a half second late. Or so. I can't, whoa, wait. Wait a minute.
I feel the need. The need for speed.
Yes, thank you for the vault. Appreciate it. Oh dear god, come on. I don't know these maps. I don't know them very well. So I don't know what the search pattern is. So I'm kind of just, you know, blind by seeing my pants. But as I learn them, then I'll, you know, I'll be able to figure out, okay, this is the route to do it. But like I said, I mean, I don't have that much time anymore. How did I miss her? That's whatever. I thought for sure that would have been taken, but...
Okay.
Yeah, I realize I should probably be putting points into my killer, but I'm trying to get up to where you guys are, Andy. So I'm basically just sacrificing my killer's ability to get up to where you guys are, roughly, like, 2 or 3 perks. Oh no, that's why I figured I'd get up there with, I'm trying to get to where Gabe is in level on a survivor. I don't know what level he is. Matter of fact, I should probably ask him. Almost wondering if I should put half of my points pool into my killer as the survivor, because right now I'm basically trying to power level my survivor off of my killer's games. I don't know. I realized that was almost immediate. God damn, come on now. I saw somebody just now. Make a play. No, as far as I'm concerned, I got points already for putting on a hook, so... eat okay. Really? He's trying to lead me away from him. God, I just barely missed. What the hell? They're doing the goal, get the jimmies to 90%, believe them till the end. That's a sign of survive with friends using TS or Discord. Ah. Guess what, buddy? For all the trouble you've caused me, I am breaking with tradition. I usually am pretty fair, and I stay away, but I think we're gonna camp you. Just park right here so nobody can get in front of me. The entire group is all talking to each other. The only surefire defense is to stand on top of them. Can't I get through there? She's a dumb one. I'm so sorry. I'm not. Die. Not a single thing was said. That's what I like to call a lesson in hubris. Get too cocky, too overconfident, something's always gonna bring you back down to level. Thanks, Andy. That doesn't happen that often. I can count on one hand how many times I've gotten everybody. I was only 200 points off the top scoring survivor. That would have probably been one or two good chainsaw runs. All right. Alright, welcome back, Andy. You'll be heading off soon? Are you gonna start streaming here in a little bit? Yeah. 7 hours of this game, just about. You might? Okay. I might have to make, like, a marathon of this on the weekend so I can get up to... so I can see what Gabe's level's at on his Survivor. So at least I can get somewhat close. We got a saboteur. Get there. Ah, almost there too. Oh my God, really? Twice! The same person! Twice! Oh, that saboteur's been busy. God dang it, really? Two times. Oh, this sucks. do stream, I'll show you some tips. Not saying I'm any good as I face rank 1 killers and survivors, but can at least show in person how I play. Okay. God dang it. Freaking cooldown. Little girl, run! Yeah, that backfired on you pretty good, didn't it? Oh, looks like all my points are gonna come from my chainsaw friends. That was weird. One of those gray guys. Oh boy. Alright, let me real quick put my points over the survivor. Ooh, rank 8. Nice. Or level 8. Level 8. Level 8, not rank. Jesus. That's kind of neat, I guess. Thank you. Okay, Andy. Thanks for stopping by. Have a good one, man. I'll if I see you on before I head off, I'll drop you a host. I probably have another game or so in me. All right, take it easy, Andy. We'll see you later. Seems like the only time I ever get my lurkers to type is if there's some controversy. Yeah, the lurk is very strong in this channel. That's why I have, oh, here, Andy, if you haven't seen this video. That would be me falling asleep on the stream for about 30 seconds, because I had no soul talking to me, keeping me awake. Notice, when I do fall asleep, my head does not move at all. Can't shock, can't talk, shooting mutants. Oh God. My head didn't move. I kept level the whole time. I didn't fall forward on my face or nothing. And no, guys, I'm not going bald. My hair is naturally parted that way. And I usually have the matted hair look anyway, so it's kind of hard to tell. Get your forehead hair. Yeah, I did a 24-hour stream that weekend. Turned around and did let's see, I did. So I did a 24-hour stream, woke up and did another freaking, I think, 16 hours, and then I was already at 50 hours when I started dozing off. One of the best clips ever. Yeah, I had Kryptonic in the channel, and I just so happened to doze during a cutscene that translated into a transition scene. And that happened, and it just so happened that everybody saw it. The alien, how are you doing? Oh God, 30 hours. The most I ever did staying up consecutively was in college when I did over 100 hours. And that was because we were on finals week. And I was cramming like crazy to study as much as possible. And the funny part being, I stayed up for 100 hours, got everything crammed, Went, took my first test. Now this is where it gets good. Took my first test, finished that test, and promptly passed out. Because that was one of those exams where you couldn't just, you know, finish your exam and get up and leave. You had to wait till the end of class. So I had to sit there and wait. And I promptly conked out, fell out of my chair, and apparently was very entertained because apparently I was talking in my sleep while curled up in the fetal position. Dark Mutt LPM, thank you for the follow, I appreciate it. I was still because I messed with the Skyrim, but it broke. Yeah, I've had some really strange happenings when I've fallen asleep. Those F-14s bring back memories? Yeah. My favorite aircraft of all time. I saw it. What was it? I was, I think, 5 years old, and I saw it at an air show, and I was like, that is the coolest freaking, that is the coolest plane ever. Really? I have to say, they have a video on YouTube of sunsetting the F-14, and I had a tear. I had a tear, quite literally. I don't know. Should I camper, guys, or should I go find somebody else? I feel like she was just sitting there and really wasn't being that ridiculous, so I think I'm gonna give her a chance. I had a tear when the video when they sunsetted the F-14. I was like, oh my god, it's my favorite aircraft. I grew up with it, you know. Damn it. That was my bad. Mistake. Wait, did she go down? Did she freaking... She went downstairs. She went downstairs. I guess I was wrong. Tucson, the infamous aircraft boneyard. Yep. I've been there. I've been to the aircraft boneyard. There was a story actually way back of a, you know, the Marine Corps, how they get the hand-me-downs and whatnot. Well, apparently they didn't have enough F-18s. And the Navy was transitioning to the Super Hornets. They had to actually go to the aircraft boneyard and pick up a whole bunch of F-18 C's and D's. That have been sitting there for like 3 years. That happened. Oh my god. Like survival, but it's really difficult sometimes as killer because I can't find anybody. I swear to god, run circles around me and I never notice them. Well, you missed the three trolls I had earlier, enemy. Or my the four trolls, I should say. The four. Oh my god, I missed by half a freaking... On the Stupor Hornet. I'm still salty over the fact that they decided to get rid of the 14. Nothing ever got close enough to go into actual furball mode with the Tomcat. Ever. So to retire it, just to me seems stupid. Yay. Let's see, there's a corridor I can run down. The 15 is in the Air Force, it still exists. I just thought it was funny how they go, oh, the F-15 has over 110 kills to zero. They take three F-15s to put up against a single F-22, and the F-22 kicks all their asses. It's like, oh, did I mention that you don't have the throne anymore? The 35 is a scary, scary aircraft. The 35 has the ability to melt electronics. That's how powerful its radar is. The funny part is, I'm only a civilian and I know this stuff. Oh, do we have a... Stroik. Stroik. Do you remember there was a really famous aircraft analyst, right? And he actually kind of made fun of Russian technology. He said, whereas the U.S. goes towards building something with a scalpel, the Russians go after it with a sledgehammer. And I was like, well, that's kind of a strange analogy, but I guess it I didn't do too good there. I got room for one more game if it's quick. Yeah, the, what was the analogy? A single F-35 could take out the entire power infrastructure of California. All by itself. Alright, Andy. Have a good one. I will, I'll see you later today. But, yeah, have a good one. Good old growler, yes. Yeah. The alien, it can get pretty ridiculous. Have a good feeling about it? I don't know. I don't know. Well, let's just put it this way, Strike. What you know is the very tip of a very large distance. And with a little bit of disinformation thrown in. You ever heard of the term, for every one you know, there's 100 that you don't? That sums up the whole stealth program. So by mere statistics, so you shot down one. Okay. Oh my god, I swung early. God, really? I fooled ya. Did I? Fucking stupid. I am dumb. Oh my god. I don't know. This is not good. This one is probably a Survive with Friends episode right here. Wow. I freaking suck. Holy crap. I think I need to put some points in my freaking killer. I'm absolutely horrendous. Did I knock a freaking... Yeah, I thought I did. Where'd you go? Come on. Really? This just sucks. I know it. Give you some delicious cookies before you die. No? Alright. I love you. I'll have all the cookies I want then. Doesn't stun me, silly. All right, alien, take it easy, man. Have a good one. All right, take it easy, alien. Have a good one, man. Line up and go.
Salt coming.
Nothing? 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 Why is there nothing?